should start at this point, should try to create a script that promotes these two DCs. So I'm going to connect to DC1. Actually, I'm going to boot up my DHCP while I'm waiting. DHCP is an IPM. I'm going to sign into DC1, set my IP address up, install the software, and rename.
I didn't upload the recording from last class here because I just, everyone was walking out of here glassy-eyed, not knowing what I was saying.
Guys, you can create one big massive script, or you can create a bunch of little small scripts. It's up to you. I'm going to change my screen resolution. Yes.
You said that if we want to run individual like portions of it, right? You said we have to add the first pipelines, the authentication, instead of the
correct.
Yeah, the 60 seconds.
Correct. Let me point that out as well. So let's say you don't want to do it like with the start sleep or some sort of manual rehearse to continue. Everywhere there's a sleep, if I select this right now, and only this, if I select these two blocks, or these three blocks and try to run them, these variables won't be set. So I would need to copy these down to right here so I can reset the variables. Because once I highlight something and not run it, if there's any variables and when I select it, I need to reset those variables. Right. And that's another way to do it. I have a lot of students who just create little snippets that they highlight that snippet, press play. Let it do its thing. When that's done, highlight the next section, press play. So I'm mainly doing the DHCPs, the DCs on the DCs. I just want one more people here. Listen, guys, I have a job lead at Panther State. The network admin used to be a student of mine years ago. During off season of hockey season, what happens is they do a lot of events and they need additional tech help. So they have a temporary part time position to do tech help, a lot of supporting PCs, supporting point of cells, cash registers, things like that. Everyone who's been through that likes that position. They gave them a lot of experience to support evenings and weekends. If you're interested in that, send me your resume. I'll send it over to them. Your resume, I sent off. Okay. To Blue House. So I don't have any resumes to send to Panthers right now. I mean, literally, I have no one looking for a job. The people that were looking for a job, I called them up and say, I'm going to send your resume out, and they go, don't bother another job. So if you're interested in something like that, let me know. Guys, I'm going to put it up here so it saves my work after I close the window. It'll kind of recover the work. New, I'm on a DC1, new net IP address. Press number lock. So guys, I'm running this on the machine, but you could have encoded this in the script block.
highlight everything, press F8, come on.
Guys, I'm gonna press F8 to reboot my machine. Machine, but you don't have to be on a virtual machine. You can do this from your real machine. highlight those two commands. That was 4 minutes.
Thank you.
So guys, this is all part of my reboot. If I was going to start sleep, it'd be 10 minutes. I'm going to create my reverse. and create a point of record for myself. And that could be that guy. I'm just showing you what I did. This is what I did with those two commands. Created this zone, created that record. I'll come back in 1 second. Guys, after that runs, you can press play on the DHCP script. Let's do its thing. Guys, of course, you have to have your DC and your IPM up and running. I mean, if they're not running, that script won't work well. Guys, in 2019, I know there's a lot. You're the second person that has it. When your machine reboots, it comes up with a black screen. So if you just close the window and reopen it, it works. Again, you don't want to run the DHCP script until this is all done. So guys, if you look, my script is still installing software. My DHCP script is still installing software. So we can move on to DHCP2 while the DHCPs are being configured. The only thing that's not configured is the developer, which you can add.
Okay. I can start the whole script, right?
Yeah, is your DHCP1 fully up and running?
Yeah.
Yeah, as long as you've done this, these two commands, do these and then. Run on the real machine.
The one off of T2O.
Right.
Okay. Then you have the credential card to after every sleep, right?
Only if you don't want to use the start sleep. If you use the start sleep, you don't have to.
I don't have to use the start sleep?
Right.
Oh.
You only need to do that if you're just doing every little section at one time. If you just press play, you can run the whole script at one time, you'll set the variable at the beginning, wait a little bit, move on to the next one. It's only when you highlight one section and press play, and highlight the next section and press play.
Oh, okay, so I don't have to.
want to check on my DHCP script. Guys, it gave me a warning that my DC2 isn't up and running because it's saying that's not a valid DNS server. It's not yet, so I'm not worried about it. Okay. It will be eventually. So, guys, I'm now on DC2. DC2 is going to point to DC1 for name resolution. I'm going to come back. Highlight all that and press restart. Guys, I'll be right back. I'm going to go check. So my DHCPs are done. I'm on DC1. Look, I have three computers joined to the main. I have a reverse lookup. I go to Active Directory users and computers. My computer's already there. So my DHCPs are done. I'm just going to sign into DHCP1. DHCP2, and then the IPAM. Okay, guys, here's my commands for BC2.
Sign as a domain in BC2, right?
Correct. Make them over there. See if I can spot it. So right here, we're going to say, rerun that top one.
Guys, I'm going to highlight everything. And run it.
It's what I'm encouraging. In between that, where does the reboot, you've got to put your appropriate amount of sleep. Like after promoting, I might have to sleep 10 minutes. After rename, maybe 1 minute. You know, because after you promote your domain control, there's a long wait. So yes, your goal is to take those commands and nest them inside of invoke block and practice them until you get it completely automated. Guys, how many people came to the when they had that recruitment visit? Okay, what was one of the things that they said? They need people that know how to do automation. That's what they're looking for. They said they need people that know how to do scripting. Guys, on DC2, I'm going to promote this to the domain controller. Guys, I could put a variable here instead of doing this. I could pass it in an authentication object, or I could have it prompt me for the password. So right now I'm just having it prompt me. Highlight those two commands and press play. Guys, I'll be right back. I'll come back to this in 1 second. I want to see some other things.
Okay, guys, here's what I'm back on DC2. Guys, after you press, after you run selected, take your first break. Guys, if you want to avoid that, put the dash F. Now you know what the force does. You literally asked me that question, I think it's yesterday. Okay, guys, when it doesn't join automatically, go in and try to manually join it. If something doesn't work, find a new way around. Guys, there's another problem that occurred. I'll get to that in a little bit. I'll explain what the other problem is. Guys, I'm gonna press run selected. Can I hit enter? Okay, do you need a picture? Take a break. Guys, with the fix one little issue, and I'll show you what it is, then join the view file over, configure the ICAM, and everything we've done so far is done. So far up to this semester. Okay. I'm going to assume that you already have the first part worked out. I'm going to assume you went through the lab, you automated the first part. Or you can have a variable at the top and just change it once. There's all kinds of things you can do. Thank you.
Okay, guys, can I show you the error that I created unknowingly for you? Hello. I told you don't have to wait for DC2 to be up and running. Well, because we did it out of order like that, when it tried to do this line in my DHCP, this failed. It didn't create DNS servers in the DHCP. So we can solve that by doing this. Just putting one in our script. So in the future, because it tried, what it did was, well, the other thing I could do is, let me look. Well, I can't do it here because I don't have DHCP installed. The other thing I could do is there's a switch saying don't validate the DNS servers. When it tried to do this, DC2 wasn't up and running. So I tried to validate 172.16.0.3. That server wasn't up and running yet, so this part failed. So just do this for right now. Or I can look up the command. DHCP PowerShell. No, they actually have to be up and running. So your solution is, in this script, get rid of the .3. So if you do it out of order, you won't have an issue. Right now, to fix that issue, go to DHCP1. Then go to scope options. You see that there's no DNS servers there. Go down to 006. See how it validates? That's what's killing us. Then click OK. Like I said, that poll, every time I look and look at that poll in my peripheral vision, I think someone's raising their hand.
The poll that goes.
No, if you do it on one, it'll copy it over. Just remember, it's working now, but it's not optimal.
Okay.
Correct. If you do both these CDs, then you'll be fine. You want me to come back? Okay. Yeah. Guys, when you add an IP, it validates the IP, make sure it's a valid DNS server. It will be a valid DNS, but it wasn't up and running at that point. So guys, you click OK, and then the last thing you need to do, hopefully you do this with your script, I'm giving you some little research project, I even showed you where to get the information, config your developer. Just like we did during the lab. Guys, you have funky naming conventions. You go with the name that you chose. Click next. So right there, I just typed in my name, whatever the real name of that machine is. If you don't know it, go to that machine and look it up. Click next. Guys, what's our load balancing? 50. I don't want a message. Remember when the script I showed you, I'll be right back to this. When I showed you that script, we had two scripts we could do. We could do one for load balancing or hot standby. Two versions of that script. So I'm going to go back to DHCP. Load balancing or hot standby. We're going to do load balancing. No authentication message. Click next, then finish. I just typed the name. I'll be back to you. DCs, DTPs, DNS servers are done. We're moving on to IPAM. I have already installed the software with my script. Time to ask that question, not 10 minutes into the lab. Some questions are appropriate. It's the timing. I literally have people in this class
that have only shown up the first day. I don't know how they're going to pass. Guys, make sure you sign in as Contoso Access Commissioner. Okay, so I'm going to jump to two. I'm already connected to one. One is already completed. So I'm going to provision. Again, this doesn't provision. We have to run that command. We have to run the PowerShell command. So the only thing I'm changing in this wizard is adding IPAM. Let's do this thing for a greater database, then we run the PowerShell command. Okay, give me 1 second. I'm going to type this command out so they can start typing while I'm helping you. Okay. Invoke IPAM provisioning. Domain is Contoso. The prefix is IPAM. Guys, again, you gotta know your server name. We have these weird boxes pop up. Again, everyone who's taken the certification exam has had to type this command into the user. You don't have to have complete. You have to memorize it. Our
was the time the war on Democrats, which is repeated here. I haven't tried it, guys, but I imagine that if you lead off at IPM in Wizard, it will work fine. But I'm not going to try. ATP stuff. The PowerShell commands that I'm giving you in class that look very foreign, you know, these ones that I have here, where would you get those from? Or you could just read your book. They're all in the book. They're just, you know, it's telling you everything you need right from the book. So if you need information, your book is a good resource too. Look, they're even having you install it. Guys, and they're not only doing that, they're giving you old school commands from Windows 2000 days using that shell. So they're even going old school on you. So everything that we've done so far is in the book. Everything. I'm going to come back and help someone, then we're going to continue with the IBM. Guys, I'm going to close this down. No, I'm not. not. I'm just going to leave it up and just minimize it. I'm going to go to configure server, discovery, get forest. Guys, if it's blank, click get forest. It's a glitch. Click OK, then reopen it, and it'll be there. Then click add. Get forest, OK, reopen it, add. Then start discovery. That takes a while. Discovery, guys, I can click here, or just jump to server inventory. Mine only found two. I don't know why this is so screwy. So, go to task, click add servers, CS01, DHCP1, DocuMtoso.com, click verify. For me, this is the DHCP server. CS01, DHCP2, Contoso. Verify. DHCP managed. Now for DC1 and DC2, I'm changing it to manage. This is where I'm stopping the video. Guys, what I would do, in this case, so every machine has a GPIO, shut down all the machines other than the DCs. Once those are all down, shut them down within here. Don't just kill them. Shut them down from within. Reboot the DCs. Once the DCs are up, boot these other machines up. Give it a little bit of time, then check this again. When they're all added and they're all set to manage, and they have the right thing checked, I'm going to assume it's going to work. So for this one, I'm just going to shut down this machine. Shut down my two DHCP servers. Called member servers. They're joined to the domain, but they're not domain controllers. Any server joined to the domain that's not a domain controller is a member server. So you want to shut down all your member servers, reboot your DCs. Once your DCs are up, boot the member servers.
So shut down DHCPs as well.
Right.
And then boot the DCs.
And then once they're up, boot up the IPM. Boot up the DHCP servers and the IPM. I'll do the DHCP server first.
Oops.
Give me 1 minute. I would boot up the DHCP server before I boot the IPM.
Oh. Okay.
I also
guys, the other thing is, get in the lab, practice. Go in with other people. I'm there from 2:30 to 6. Come to my office if you need it. When I first walk in the door, there's generally something waiting for me that I have to take care of. But after a half hour, I'm kind of free. I don't have a solution.
Two people possibly at work in the same conversation. The only solution I can say is, when they adjust, I'm not going to mark it off. Is rebuild the whole machine.
So they have to go into the end of the scratch.
Yeah, but if you run into that issue, I'm not going to mark you off. Just leave that screen off on the data test. Guys, give us a little bit of time. If you know that they're all managed and the proper things are checked, this should unblock itself with time. Okay. I'm stopping the video. You gotta be patient.